Hi and welcome to the first episode of our DermLite on the spot dermoscopy series. So we have to we have a little bit of housekeeping, but let me just say overall the concept. We hope to provide you with some practical insights, tips, and tricks you can apply immediately at the point of care. So while you're literally on the spot looking through your DermLite, and the idea is to keep this short. We'll try to wrap it up in less than 30 minutes. It's our first episode, so please bear with us. We'll have to see how this goes. So in case you don't already know me, my name is Thorsten Trotzenberg. I'm the co-founder and the guy in charge of product design at 3Gen. 3Gen is the company behind DermLite, of course. I've been responsible for the design of every DermLite ever made, starting with our first product, and which was the world's first polarized dermatoscope. So in this first installment of the On the Spot series, our goal is to sort of lay the groundwork for future episodes by touching on some basic questions. So Andreas Blum will answer things like, what is polarized light? How does polarized and non-polarized light change the appearance of, various features? And, there's some tips and tricks he has, like what do you do when the lesion is just a little too large for your smartphone. So I'm excited to have Professor Andreas Blum kick off this series. He actually made the mistake of being the first to ask us whether we were going to put on something like this. And now he can't escape having to present in front of this wonderful global audience. We have people from over 50 countries attending this webinar. No pressure, Andreas. So for those of you who don't know Dr. Blum, he's based in southern Germany, and he's one of the world's pioneers in skin cancer diagnostics. His clinical research has resulted in numerous publications and books on dermoscopy. So hello and welcome, Andreas.
Oh, hello, Thorsten, and hello to everybody worldwide. Happy to be here and thankful to be here and thankful to you, to your team that you organize this and you say, oh, it's a good idea. We try this. Thank you.
Thank you, Andreas, for doing this. Actually, I'm very grateful to you and all those who've been supporting our efforts to expand dermoscopy knowledge everywhere. And I'm truly, I'm really humbled by the way our products and ideas have, over the last 20 years, revolutionized the way most of you do dermoscopy. In a way, I feel like when we support training you in dermoscopy and equip you with the DermLite, we've sort of given you superpowers. And actually, yesterday when I was preparing for this, I wondered how many of you would agree with the idea of these superpowers, or maybe some of you would want to obtain a superpower. So I thought, why not introduce the idea of polling on this Zoom webinar by asking you basically this question, and you'll see it pop up right now, and you'll have a chance to give an answer here. So choose. it's multiple choice. You can pick as many as you like. In dermoscopy, maybe prophecy might come in handy. You'll know ahead of time what your pathologist might say, or clinical outcome, where that next tumor is going to pop up before it's even there. I don't know. If you agree with my DermLite superpowers, pick number 7.
I cannot choose here.
No, sorry, Andreas.
Oh, why not? Okay.
You can talk later. You have superpowers.
That's good. It's good.
So everyone voted. We still have some votes coming in. I'm going to end this, and let's take a look.
Wow.
Here we are. Teleportation wins out.
Very good. Very good.
So now that you know how the poll works, you'll have a chance to answer more questions later on. And another topic is questions. You might see that Q&A, or I don't know what that button might be called in your app or on your end. You can ask questions. You can chat. So you can ask at any time, and we'll try to squeeze it in. We'll try to get Andreas to answer them. I'm not sure how many we can fit in. So anyway, we're ready to begin. So Andreas, the stage is yours. You are on the spot.
So thank you very much, Thorsten. Once again, thank you very much to your very nice and very successful group to provide this new kind of continuing medical education. And I'm very happy that a lot of participants around the world are here. And so what I like to do in the next few minutes, 20, 25 minutes, to start the first episode about this DermLite spot. DermLite spot. So on the spot, which you see here, and you see an older photo from myself, and I say welcome to everybody. So welcome. Thank you to be here, and let us start. So just to have a short glimpse to our world and where is Germany, and you see here this little arrow, and just here in the center of this yellow circle, there's Germany located, and just in the south of Germany, southern than Munich, there's a huge lake, and now you know exactly where I am staying. It's called Constance, Lake of Constance, so the name of this lake. And here, a glimpse, a view. We are here located, and when I look out, I see the beginning of the Alps southwards, and there's Switzerland, and behind is Italy. And this is our lake, and we have still sun, not a lot of rain. This is very bad for our area here, but so this is our spot. So we like to start this first episode, and we have named this for lights and physics. And here's now the first question to you. You see here an elbow of a 70-year-old female and change, not sure. So I always ask for the change in the last 3 months. So the first question to you here from clinical point of view, benign or malignant? What do you think? So please have a look and then vote for yourself. You get sometimes quite a question, some questions for us and for your voting. And so it's a kind of educative steps to see what do you think and how can we approach to the lesions with a very basic knowledge about light and physics. Okay? Yeah, benign, more about around 2/3 benign, around 1/3 malignant, something like this. Okay, thank you very much. It's very helpful. Thank you. Now we take the dermoscope. We are here in lessons for dermoscopy. And here you see the dermoscope. And when you have a look to this, you would say, okay, I can have two different types of dermoscopic images. One is polarized and the other one is non-polarized. So is this, for example, a blue nevus? Now, how to approach this problem? And we go here a little bit into the physics, into the light, and it is very basic and comprehensible that you understand it and you have fun when you take the next time your dermoscope, you exactly know what's going on with the light. So for example, you look at the lesion with your eye, with your eyes, and there's nothing on the skin. So you look inside with the light of the, for example, from the room, of the sun, and you have the reflection at the epidermis. It's nearly 100% reflection. So for example, you look at this lesion and you can't say anything. Is this a sepK or an irritated sepK or sepK with perhaps a darker angioma or something like this? You don't know. Yeah. But then you can take a glass plate and put it on the lesion and with a light, for example, of a dermoscope, or even of the, of a room. You can look a little bit inside to the skin here. You see the error, it's the reflection is very few, but you see some parts of the parts of the epidermis, perhaps at the basal membrane, but more on the upper part of the epidermis. So you have a little bit of more visible structures, and you see here a little bit, some few dots in this area here, a little bit eccentric, yeah, and then more and less no features in dermoscopy which you can use. Now we take a glass plate with a little bit of immersion fluid, and then we apply, and this is all included in the dermoscope with this magnification, and then we apply this instrument on the skin, on the lesion, and then we can look inside, also illuminated by LEDs, and now we get a very good insight and possible reflection of the structures inside to the lens, which we can see here with our eye. And then we have a good reproduction. And then we see the lesion here. And now you would say, no, this is not a SEPK. Stop. There's a SEPK, yes. Here at the periphery. But here there's a typical pigmented lesions with a lot of dots, with a little bit of a typical network, broadened network, a very short hint, perhaps of pseudo network, pseudopods here at the periphery. But this gives us a hint there's something malignant, and this should be a melanoma. Okay? So only based to the lights and physics, we know how to approach such a lesion and to see inside up to 2 millimeters of the epidermis and basal membrane. So to summarize this first step, with non-polarization, when we look inside and with a glass plate and immersion fluid, we have a better view with a good reproduction of the upper part of the first part of the skin, that means epidermis till the basal membrane. We also can see in deeper parts, but not so good if the reproduction is adequate. When there's a phone. When we use polarization light and no glass plate, no immersion fluid, we can also see inside to the epidermis and basal membrane, but for me, the results of the visibility is reduced. And then the best option would be if you take the dermoscope for myself and the glass plate and immersion fluid, then we can have a very good visibility and reproduction around the basal membrane, which is a key area for the dermoscope, because here are the lesions, here are the cells in which we are interested in. The question now to us is, what is the physics of the polarization? And it is very simple. Non-polarization means the lights come in and you have a kind of scattered reflected light. And in polarization, we do have not scattered, but parallel. So that means here the light is a little bit fuzzy, not so clear. We do not see the structure so clear. And here we do have the very clear structures, either with non-contact, but not so many cases, and with contact and with fluid, we do see it's very bright and very good, and no scattered diffuse light, but very parallel and clear light. And this is the advantage of the polarization, which one we should use. So to summarize this in a little table, non-polarization, we have the optimal visible skin level from the epidermis to basal membrane. And with polarization, we have more the visibility, the best optimum from the basal membrane to the upper part of the dermis, stratum papillaris of the dermis. And now we can use this for visible features. For example, in the seborrheic keratosis, we see much better the media-like cysts in non-polarization light, because it's very in the upper part of the epidermis. In contrast, when we are interested in different types, for example, white lines or chrysalis and melanoma, spitzneval, BCC, dermatofibroma or angioma as well, then we can use, we see it in polarized light. And also the, in actinic keratosis for the rosettes, for the shiny areas, and also in granuloma pyogenicum. And this is also important, and here there's a big advantage for the polarization light, is we do see the much better the blood vessels of the dermis. And when you use or you are familiar with dermoscopy, you know that the blood vessels, or you will learn this, that the blood vessels has a very high impact in diagnosing skin lesions. Have this in mind when you use your dermoscope with polarization and non-polarization, and when you are interested in different levels of the skin to diagnose. Now we come back to our lady with the elbow. You remember, 70-year-old, change unsure, and 2/3 of you said it is benign. It's a benign lesion. Now, I've shown you this lesion with non-polarization and the question blue nevus. And now, with polarization, and now the question is, again, for you voting, what do you think? It is a benign lesion or it is a malignant lesion? I'm very interesting to see now the result. Malignant, great. Thorsten, we have done a good job. We can stop here. Thank you very much for joining us. I'm happy the evening starts now in old Germany. Yay! Brilliant. You are excellent. You are very, very good. So what is the hint here? And this is one you only see with polarization. And this is very brilliant because this is a key message. Yeah, you see white lines. White line in a blue lesion, for example. Yeah, and you know exactly when I call you. And for example, when I call Ash, and I hope Ash, my group from US, is also here. Ash, please wave. No, okay. When I call Ash and I'm telling him, Ash, listen, I have a blue lesion with white lines. He would immediately say, exclude the melanoma. Yeah, and you did so. Very good. Excellent. Brilliant. So this is an invasive melanoma. Okay. So we can treat this in early stage and then to help the people. Some examples now for you. You have here, for example, 54-year-old male, and he said, here's a change of this lesion here. Yeah. And then you take the dermoscope and non-polarization, you know, left-hand side non-polarization, right-hand side with polarization, and we train this a little bit. It's always good to train in the same manner to get a feeling for the examination and for the results. So left-hand side non-polarization, right-hand side polarization. And you see here the media-like cysts, also here a little bit more shiny. Yeah, and on the right-hand side, with polarization, you see much more better the vessels. Yeah, and when you see this lesion, you know you have the seborrheic keratosis. I always also like to teach, like to force you, when you have lesion on the face, on the scalp, touch it. The seborrheic keratosis is smooth, a little bit fatty. Yeah, and I show you later on other lesions on the scalp and face which have a different touching feeling. Okay, we go to the next. You know, in Germany we are very busy, we have a lot of patients. 80-year-old male, change at the back. So change question mark, not quite sure. Yeah, at the back. And never trust a male with a lesion on the back. If a male would say there's no change, never trust him. And the wife is sending him, you know, okay, I need to remove it. Okay? Now, also non-polarization. This is the lesion. And with polarization. And now the question to you again. Please vote. It is benign or malignant? I'm very curious. Okay. Any results? Yeah, excellent. You get better and better. Brilliant, brilliant. What I like to do is just go one image back. When you have a single reddish lesion, and this is very important, you have a single reddish lesion in one patient, yeah, always take care, always be aware, always exclude clinically and especially dermoscopically the malignant lesion. So that means, is it benign or malignant? So single reddish lesion with polarization with white lines, and this is a clue either the melanoma or the basal cell carcinoma. And the hint for the basal cell carcinoma are these grayish, a little bit oval kind oval nests, and also the horizontal vessels here. Yeah. And with these white lines, you must say this is a BCC. Nevertheless, if you say, I'm not quite sure about the BCC versus the melanotic melanoma, but then you do the very good therapeutic procedure, that means you cut it out and send it to histopathology. We are good in, we are better in saying what we need to do than we are not so good in saying what is a correct diagnosis. But the most important step for the patient is to do the best therapeutic treatment as soon as possible. So you would say here, malignant, cut it out. You get the result back, basal cell carcinoma. Excellent. Next, we have a patient, not so many still hairs on his scalp, more than 80 years old, change, well. And here, I also like to force you a little bit to touch it. You see, it's a little bit rough, touch this lesion, yeah? And you see with non-polarization, and here you see it with polarization. Now, the question, what is it, yeah? And when you call me, for example, and say you have a man on the scalp with rough lesion, when I touch it, yeah, and with UV-damaged skin, I would say, well, it must be an actinic keratosis. And it's visible here in polarized light is shiny areas and with the rosettes here. Four little dots and located as a rosette, and then you know exactly I do have here an actinic keratosis. So next patient, you see this, nearly 40-year-old at the lower leg with this lesion. He said, yes, there's a change. We go now in dermoscopy, and you would say here immediately, well, I know this is a dermatofibroma, which is absolutely correct. But I also like it to have it with more clear, visible colors and also the white lines. This is a hint here for the dermatofibroma, which is post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which looks a little bit like a net at the periphery. So you have the dermatofibroma. And the next is with a little bit UV damaged skin, older female, and you find this kind of lesions in lower arms or lower legs, more in lower arms, and the skin is a little bit fair. And then you see this non-polarization, and you see here at the rim, yeah, this little bit kind of hyperkeratosis, like a little wall, and very distinctly some vessels inside, a little bit dotted, but with polarization you see this much more clearer, and also the wall at the periphery. And when you have seen this once or two times and you remember this for the next patient, then you know you have the actinic perikeratosis, also called by Mibelli, who was the first author about this lesion, which is benign, but you should ask the patients to protect against UV radiation.
Andreas, okay? Question about the previous lesion. What do the white lines represent?
The previous, I go back, correct? These are areas of fibrosis. in the part of the upper part of the dermis, and which is, as we have learned from the physics, this is only or much more better visible in polarization light. Yeah, so these are fibrosis area strings of upper part of the dermis.
Okay, yeah. What the BCC you were showing, the white lines on the BCC.
It's the same. The same pattern of the fibrosis in the upper part of the dermis. It's always the same. But you see this in different types of tumors. BCC, melanoma, spitz nevi, dermatofibroma, angioma. Okay?
Thank you.
Very good question. Thank you. Now we skip this. So the next is a lady around skin type 3 to 4, and she notices at her shoulder, and it is a rapid growing. You check this with a dermoscope, and nearly no chance to say, what is this? Yeah, homogeneous, nodular, bluish lesion, unsure, you should remove it. Yeah, but now when you use it with polarization, your dermoscope, you see this whitish areas, shiny whitish areas, also the line. And when you have this seen several times and also proven by histopathology, you know this is a dermatofibroma in darker skin type. Yeah. I try to avoid to do an operation here because we know, or my experience is that afterwards the scar is like keloid-like, and it's more an hypertrophic scar, which is complicated, much more complicated for the patients. Yeah, but for me, this is a typical dermatofibroma, a little bit with this shiny white islands here in this area here, shiny whitish areas, a little bit of white lines here at the periphery, and the dermatofibroma.
Okay, we have another question regarding the white lines. It seems to be a topic of interest. On the BCC, where are the white lines? Can you show them?
On the BCC, then I must go back. Hold on. Here we are. Up. Here. Here you see the white lines. Do you see it? Here? Here are the white lines. Yeah. And when you compare this, and I show you later on, we have a special trick between changing between non-polarization and polarization. We have a special trick. And then you can see immediately the white lines appearing and disappearing. And this is a very good trick when you do your examination, which I show you later. Okay? Now I continue here, and we go to this patient. 60-year-old, change, yes, he was sent by his wife. Yeah, and you see this quite asymmetric, atypical, pigmented a little bit at the periphery, eccentric hyperpigmentation. And to be honest, you see the white lines here. Yeah, and we call this also in this area the negative white network. And when you call, for example, now Eshmar Group in New York and telling an FN, a typical lesion, asymmetric with eccentric hyperpigmentation with white, negative white network, you would immediately say, without seeing this image, cut it out, exclude the melanoma. And in polarization light, you see this negative white network much more better. And this is also the fibrosis on the upper part of the dermis. Yeah? So white lines, white negative network, melanoma. Yeah. And it is so simple. When you have seen this now several times, you would see it in the next patient immediately and do the very good thing to send it to histopathology and to exclude any malignancy. Okay, we have next quiz for you. First, the clinic, 54-year-old male with a change. He noticed this as a change. Now, non-polarization light and with polarization light. What do you think? Benign or malignant? It's now your voting again, please. No, I'm very interesting about your result.
Come on, we need some more votes.
You're finished for voting?
Okay.
Excellent. You get better and better. Wow. You are a great group. Congratulations. Very good. Most of you are thinking it is malignant and it's absolutely correct. So that means a little bit of, so it's an asymmetric lesion inside, especially, yeah, a little bit scratched, as this one we can't use, an irritated lesion perhaps, and with atypical pigmentation inside. And then when we look to this atypical pigmentation inside with brown, a little bit whitish starting, and this one you see in polarization light, and check to this, the white lines. Here you see the white lines coming up. Yeah. And then you see immediately, oh, white lines, atypical pigmentation, gray, bluish, whitish, brown. Something goes wrong. Cut it out. Excellent melanoma, 0.7 millimeter tumor thickness. Well done. Next patient, young female is coming in, 24 years, screaming, a nodule is growing. So clinic, and you see it was well protected because perhaps it could have been bleeding. This is non-polarization light and right-hand side with polarization light. And the next question to you, it is benign or malignant. What do you think? So nodular, reddish lesion, rapid growing, no injury there before. So benign, 68, excellent. You have very good listen, and one third is saying malignant, one third is saying benign. Excellent. So the conclusion of the result is here, granuloma pyogenicum. Rapid growing, mostly after an injury or local folliculitis or something like this, and benign, growing of benign vessels very quickly. And please always, you cut it out and please always send it to histopathology to exclude the amelanotic nodular melanoma. This is very, very important for you and especially for the patient, because we have seen lesions like this, which looks like a granuloma pyogenicum. And at the end, it was an amelanotic melanoma. So please always cut it out and send it to histopathology. When I started dermatology 30 years ago, I was taught I can cut it out and don't send it to histopathology. But this is not correct. Okay? Send it to histopathology. Excellent. Next patient, and here I want to show you a little trick. 69-year-old. There's a change at his knee. And you see this with non-polarization, atypical eccentric hyperpigmentation, bluish, grayish, little bit of Milky Way. Yeah, and here, if you look very closely, some pseudopods. And now you know this must be malignant. Now we take the polarization light, and now you see here, very distinct, but here clear the white lines. And now you know exactly this must be the melanoma. Yeah, and it was an invasive melanoma. And now I show you a trick.
Okay, hold on.
Okay. Sorry?
So we have some questions.
Yes, sorry?
Case of the invasive melanoma. How do you differentiate from BCC? Is there, you know, there's an absence of pigment network, blue gray dots, maybe it's a BCC?
So in the BCC, you can have the pigmented BCC. It's a very good question. The pigmented BCC normally with oval grayish bluish nests, which represent the tumor nests of the upper part of the dermis. And also with vessels at the trunk, more horizontal vessels in the face with the nodular part, more tree like vessels. And there you have the differentiation between the BCC and melanoma. Melanoma can have either the network or the globules, like the globules pattern, but with atypical globules, with atypical network, or with streaks, yeah, or it could be also featureless and reddish, and also with an polymorphia of vessels. That means dotted, comma vessels, hairpin-like vessels, and they are different to the horizontal vessels or tree-like vessels of the basal cell carcinoma. I admit, in some cases, very rare, you can't differentiate between the amelanotic melanoma or melanoma and BCC. But here, you would do the excision and to send it to histopathology and get the result, it was malignant, either melanoma or BCC. Okay? So at the end, you see something goes wrong and you do the best treatment, that means excision and histopathology. Okay?
There are some more questions concerning PG. So what features make it a PG? No lacunae vessels.
Hold on.
The white or pink. Basically, if you can point out features, dermoscopic.
Hold on, I go back.
Provide some more insight.
So PG, it's more, PG, it's more structureless, homogeneous reddish areas, yeah, and this is based to the huge part of the lesion in which it is like a blood lake, a little bit like this, and in this there can be some fibrosis appearing, and this represents the white lines, yeah, and so you have this proliferation, this benign proliferation of vessels after any injury or inflammation. And then you have this blood vessels growing and growing with a huge amount of blood inside. Yes, blood vessels. And in some areas of the upper part of the dermis, you get the reaction of this fibrosis, which represents the white lines. Okay? Good, very good questions. Now I go back to this melanoma.
There's a question regarding basically the question is hemangioma is too different from that?
Hemangioma, there are more lacunas, that means large globules of vessels in different part of the dermis, either upper part of the dermis or middle part of the dermis. On the upper part, you see more reddish, clear reddish. And when it's going deeper and deeper, you have it more bluish, a little bit with a veil, because the reflection is not such as good as it when it is on the surface. And there are lacunas coming together, like big globules, and like an ectasia of the vessels. And there's a different, the granuloma pyogenicum is coming out of the skin, yeah, growing out, and then the epidermis gets thinner and thinner, nearly atrophic, and you see this huge blood vessels lake, and with a little bit of fibrosis. And it's coming exophytic, and in the angioma, normally it stays inside. And when you have the angioma from the elderly, where also the epidermis get a little bit atrophic, and you can also have this a little bit eruption a little bit going outside exophytic growth, but not in the manner, because this growth is very slow, not in the manner compared to the granuloma pyogenicum.
Okay. How do you differentiate between hemangioma and early angiokeratoma?
Angioma has the lacunas, and the early angiokeratoma has the lacunas as well. And here you can't differentiate, because angioma is normally very located, a single spot. Angiokeratoma is a little bit spreaded. And when you wait a little bit long enough, then you get in the center this hyperkeratosis, which you can also touch and see it by with dermoscopy. And but the globules of the vessels are more spreaded out in the angiokeratoma. And in some cases, you have a huge area, in which you have in the center different parts of globules of the vessels, of the lacunas, and then you have different parts of the visible colors, and at the periphery, it gets thinner and thinner, and then you have only the reddish single spots of the lacunas.
Excellent. Thank you.
Good. Thank you. Very good questions. I like your questions. Very good. So keep going here. So what I do with my dermoscope, and then I said to you, I want to give you some hints for our clinical work, because we are always busy in clinic, in hospital, or in the practice. Yeah. So my dermoscope is always in polarization mode, and I show you why. And the next one, if I'm thinking about any possible change when I switch between polarization and non-polarization, we call this toggle, yeah, then I do so, and I show you. You know this lesion, and you know I use it with polarization light, so I see the white lines. Yeah, okay, you see immediately it's malignant. But nevertheless, now I toggle, I show you. Switch off, now non-polarization, and you see, disappeared. I switch on, coming on. So for me it's enough, but if you have fun, you switch off and you switch on. Okay? And then you see the difference, the white lines are appearing, disappearing, and then you toggle, and then I would say, I write down in the notice on the file of the patient, toggle positive. Okay? So with polarization mode, I do the examination, and when I'm interested in if a structure, a dermoscopic feature is disappearing and coming again, then I toggle. So, also, the next question to you with this patient, and you know the elderly people are coming more and more, and we have three lesions on the back, lower right-hand side, middle, and this is a lower lesion, middle lesion, and upper lesion. And the question now to you, which is benignant? This, lower, middle, or the upper? Do we have a question? Yeah. So top, center, bottom. Sorry, my mistake. So this top, center, bottom. Which is malignant? What do you think? And now you know all the lesions are taken with polarized light normally. When I want to show you, sometimes I have different recording system. Okay. Now I'm interested for the results. So top, center, and bottom. So bottom, it is very clear, very good. Very clear, this is benign, and when you touch it, a little bit fatty, a little bit elevated. So this is SEPK. And the problem is here in the center, one part of the SEPK has dropped down. That means you see here the vessels, and not the vessels of the dermis, but not the hyperkeratosis, the acanthosis of the epidermis. Yeah, this has been dropped down. Yeah. And so this is a SEPK as well. And here, and this one you did very well, this is the patchy atypical pigmentation of this lesion with a little bit of pigmentation around folliculus, here a little bit grayish, brown part, grayish part, bluish part, patchy distribution. So you must remove this and then you know. And this is flat in the skin. Then you know something goes wrong here. This was the early invasive melanoma, then Tigo maligna melanoma. And when you touch this in the center here, it's this rough, elevated, a little bit smoothy, a little bit fatty. So this is a SEPK and then Tigo maligna melanoma, very early stage. So you can use the dermoscope either on the skin for the nails, and this will be hopefully also a very nice chapter, a very good episode for you here for the nail. You can also take it for the mucosa, and here one picture from the mucosa. You can also use it in the hairs, so you can use the dermoscope nearly everywhere. For the mucosa, years ago, nearly decades ago, we got the hint from Alfred Kopf, one of the pioneers of US in dermoscopy. He said, well, just take a transparent food wrap, put around your dermoscope, and then you can check it. But nowadays, and also your company, Thorsten, have developed this. You can also use now a new, I would say, plastic, how you would describe it?
Disposable cover or cap.
Disposable cap, and thank you very much, which you can apply this on your dermoscope and then to do the examination in either infections areas, possible infections areas, or to do it at the mucosa. So at the end, two hacks for you. One is we have large lesions and sometimes you want to record the whole lesion. And for example, to have a better overview or to send it to a colleague to get a second opinion or to do a follow up. Yeah. So in this patient, there was a change of new spots here. And now you take this with your dermoscope and you see, well, you see here a little bit of this area with four dark spots, but we do not know what's going on in the left and the right hand side. Now the trick is, it's not my trick, but I show it to you. When we have a large lesion, for example, we take now here this item to measure, and we take here our dermoscope, we know something about the range, which one we can see on one glimpse, but we do not see on the right and left-hand side. And now there's a trick here. We do use a panorama shooting mode. And this one has been inaugurated by a group of Brazil. And it is very simple. You take your smartphone and take a panoramic shooting mode with your dermoscope. And now practical example here with this congenital nevus. When you do it here and now you have the whole congenital nevus in which you see the pattern is quite normal. You can do here reimagine around 6 to 8 weeks if you want to be on the sure side, and then everybody is happy. And this has been published by a group in Brazil last year in the chat. And I like this publication very much because it is so simple. And you can use it for your follow-up. You can teach the patients here. You can show it and to teach with people, to educate, to explain with images is very helpful. And the second hack is, I always urge the patients, please do a regular self-skin examination, check it, and then the people are telling you, especially men, I can't check the back. And this has been, I have this also found in the literature. And here you can use your smartphone, put it here on this stick, and then you can take the image when you live alone or you don't want to be checked by someone else. Yeah, then you can check by yourself. And this has been also published. This is a group of New York who has published this. So with this image, I want to say for my part, this is the end, but something is coming up. And this is a glimpse from our lake. You know the lake where it is. And now we got one case, and we offered the opportunity to send one case from around this world here, from one country. And this is a man, 70-year-old male. And he has a lesion here, and you see a little bit sun, damaged skin, a little bit crusty perhaps, this area here. And now you take your dermoscope, and you see, and this is quite educative, this image, you see skin of an older man or female. And here, remember, especially at the face, that the epidermis is getting atrophic, and you see much more better the vessels. Question is, if it's here an early BCC, it is aberrizing-like vessels, not quite sure. But we are interested in this area here. And you see this asymmetric pigmentation with patchy pigmentation, a little bit grayish, brownish, black, and with the surrounding here of the pigmentation of this follicle here as well. We call this Weinhoffen eye, we like to call this donuts. If you see donuts, pigmentation around the follicle, then you know, oh, something goes wrong. But if you have an asymmetric patchy pigmentation in sun-exposed area of the skin, for example, in the face, on the scalp, always exclude the malignancy, and this has been proven by lentigo maligna. The educative part is, one, first, the vessels and atrophic elderly skin. Second, patchy asymmetric pigmentation with brown, little black, gray. And the second, third is, and then the colleagues did the surgery with the safety margin, which is excellent. And they did the surgery again and again. And this is a problem. This is the next educative hint for all of us. And I do have the same problems. A lot of patients which are getting older, and they do have a sun-damaged skin. When you do here histopathology, you check at the rims. You check at the rim, and you check if all the cells at the rim is benign. And you have the problem in UV damaged skin. Yes, you say no, it's not still not benign. And you did the next surgery, next safety margin, and again, and afterwards you have this huge defect. And afterwards here you get the results. Now the cells at the periphery are benign at the Mohs surgery. So the conclusion of the colleague was that the dermoscopy was very helpful in this patient, and they would have missed this lesion, and then it would have been becoming into the invasive melanoma. But only by the use of the dermoscope and knowledge, you can diagnose this in very early stage. So I'm coming from the end to the end. And I like to say to you, keep learning and going on the road of the passionate dermoscopy. It is quite worthwhile for you and all your patients. And I'm looking forward for the next episode, and I'm very keen what will be the next episode. It's not published yet. And at the end, I say thank you very much to you, for the DermLite team, and to all the participants around the world. Thank you very much, and please stay healthy. Thank you. Thorsten, your turn.
Okay, well, thank you, Andreas, and thank you for this very insightful and informative intro on light and physics and dermoscopy. This wraps up our first episode of On the Spot, and I'd be excited to have you back for our next episode. And actually, on that note, we're curious what would be of most interest to you, and we have another poll, so we'd be really excited to get those answers. So you've already submitted a lot of ideas for future episodes, so a poll is one way to maybe drive us in one way or another. Okay.
Now I'm also very interested.
Sure. It's 3, 2, 1. All right. So let's share this.
Yeah. Tricky cases. Great. We have a good section about tricky cases.
Yeah, very good. After you leave, actually, you'll have a chance to leave us with some quick feedback. So we'd really appreciate getting your thoughts, your opinion on how we did today, this being our first one. And for Andreas and I think the entire 3Gen team, thank you for taking the time to be here today. And depending on where you are, have a great evening, an enjoyable morning, wonderful rest of your day, and a fun weekend. So make sure to use your superpowers and stay healthy. Thanks again.
Stay healthy. Thank you. Bye.